don't give up. If this is really what you want to do, do it, because I know, you know, people have their opinions and people don't want to, a lot of people want to see you grow, the people that care about you, and a lot of other people, they don't. So they'll try to, you know, knock you off your feet and say things that will hurt, but if this is really what you want, do it. I am a musician. I started at a really young age. At 8 years old, my mom put me in piano lessons, and ever since then, it just kind of developed and grew. And, you know, I went on my first tour when I was 14 years old, and that changed my life, definitely. I knew at that point that I just wanted to do that for the rest of my life. You know, music was always there in my life. It was always the most important thing to me, so that's like a good definition of who I am. I have a lot of appreciation for people, and I love to learn new things. I've been playing bass for, I think, 5 years now. Guitar since I was 12, so 8 years, and piano since I was 8. My mom has always been really influenced with music in her life, so she always wanted us to have that factor in our lives. I started putting YouTube videos in like 2011. At the time, I had quit School of Rock because I thought I was getting kind of old for it. But I still wanted to, you know, keep learning new songs and keep practicing. And so I thought posting videos on YouTube for, like, you know, pretty much everyone to have access to would help me keep practicing for a really good reason. So I posted a few covers in 2011, and the first time it really hit me that I thought maybe I could do, like, keep on going was I posted a Rage Against the Machine cover when I was like 16 on bass, and it grew. I was only 16, and I, you know, it was like my third video, so I saw it one day, I just watched it, and it had like 70,000 views, so I'm like, that's pretty good for, like, you know, not really doing this whole YouTube thing. So I kept going, and last year I reached, you know, a couple million views on some of my videos, and it really helped me to want to keep posting videos. Especially going to NAMM last weekend, it just made me so happy, like meeting all these people that watch my videos and just have like so much appreciation for what I do. Just talking to all these people that they get motivated by watching my videos. So it honestly is like the best feeling ever.
I would say a couple of the challenges I've faced are, you know, being a girl in the music industry, and I used to be in a couple metal bands. It attracted a lot of attention from the audience, just being like one of the very, very few girls, especially in the San Diego music scene when I was down there. You know, and like, there's always like that one guy that has something to say with a, you know, female musician on stage. But I've definitely learned to kind of just like use it to my advantage and have it make me a stronger person. So just like any sort of like sexist comments or anything like that, I just always use that as empowerment.
This mom, who was maybe like 35 years old, had a really young daughter, and she tweeted me and she said that, Anna, my daughter really looks up to you, and she just picked up her first guitar because she wanted to learn how to play guitar because of watching your videos. And I
you know, I responded and I said that that was really motivating for me, because having young girls, you know, I know how hard it is to be a female musician, because it's such a male-oriented career path, but, you know, having, you know, young females, young girls watch my videos and feel motivated to pick up a guitar, just, it makes me so happy.
Thank you.